Thank you. I wanted to start the vlog with a thank you, like from the bottom of my heart. Thank you. Because in April, when I started vlogging, I think I had about 700 subscribers from a channel that had sat dormant for years. And I started creating a family, a community where we all get together and chat about things that affect us, where I share a heart-to-heart on things that have affected me, that affect me, things that are real. And here's December and we're at 15,000 in the family. So thank you so, so, so much. You have made my dreams come true. So I hope in one way or another in 2019, I made a difference in your life because you have been everything for me in 2019. You've been my solace. You have been my purpose and my reason. I don't know if I ever explained why I started to vlog, but I used to go through different videos on YouTube. I love especially the green calabash. It's a family vlog. I love Caroline Motoko. That's not secret. And I used to say, oh, you know, they have found their purpose in life. They know what they're supposed to be doing. What's mine? Until one day I said, you know what? There's a lot I'm going through in life, and there's no way I'm the only one going through this stuff. There's no way the stuff that has happened to me throughout my maybe 20s, there's no way it's just me. So I said, why don't I use my voice to tell the real truth? You know, not the truth that is sugar-coated, but you know, just the truth about life. And for some reason, we clicked, you and I. So thank you so much for being a part of my family. If you are here watching for the first time, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Flavia Tumsime Kabura, and I am a news anchor with NTV in Uganda and also a radio host with Capital FM here in Uganda. And I'm a content creator and just all-round sister, okay? So hopefully 2020 will still be family. If you haven't subscribed, please do. And click that notification bell, that way you don't miss a thing. What happened last week? We're coming back. So, last week was quite interesting, you guys. I probably looked good. I probably felt like $1 million. But then a few hours in, my feet were swollen, my back hurt. And I said, okay, this is what happens when you're grown and you're pregnant at an awards ceremony. You're out. You can only slay the red carpet for 30 minutes. But that's the A. Bryan Style and Fashion Awards. And I would like to show you from the beginning, from me, you know, getting hair and makeup, because one of our partners going forward for hair and makeup will be Posh Junction Saloon. That's where my journey to the ASFAs 2019 started. Here you go. So the Air Bryant's Talent Fashion Awards, I've been attending for the last, I think, three or four years thereabout. And for every single year, of course, it's no secret, my favorite designer has always, and still is, Beryl Couture, Anita Beryl. She's even dressed me for my wedding. But there's a young Ugandan designer, I don't even know if she wants to be called young, to be honest. Ugandan designer, Peponi, Sarah Martha, who approached me and wanted to dress me. And why not? Anything that's got women on it, I'm definitely supporting. And my. Peponi clothing, Eugene, you outdid yourself. The outfit was stunning. I was afraid of the bump look, but apparently that wasn't the biggest worry on that dress. I mean, the color was stunning. The theme for the year was Let the Star in You Shine. She made sure there was a bit of glitter, some light, you know, a showstopper dress. So Peponi, thank you so much. If you're ever in Uganda and you want to look good, you want to dress good, make sure you find Peponi Clothing UG, and they're anywhere on social media. So thank you. I got to walk the red carpet with my loves, my sisters from Capital Radio. And yeah, it was quite fun. You know, you're all in different dresses. You get to be dolled up and pose and have all this fun. So yeah, it was great. Fourth time coming to the ASFAs, and I enjoyed it. Just in case you don't have a clue what the ASFAs are, the A. Bryant Style and Fashion Awards is just that, style and fashion. It's the award, everybody who's been stylish, fashionistas, everybody in the industry. So from makeup to stylists to innovators in the fashion industry, they do get the awards. And I think I got one a couple of years back. So yeah, this has been part of my life. I hope next year I get a chance to slay again. Probably the baby won't be crying then, but I'll try. But yeah, so that was all the fun we could have at the A. Bryant Style and Fashion Awards for 2019. So what happens when the ASFAs 2019 are done and you're exhausted as I was? Well, I had been telling my husband, we kind of need a staycation. I keep seeing everybody do staycations. We need one. Not that, you know, we go swimming and, you know, stay at a place the whole day. I mean, you know, just be pampered. Just relax and do all that. And we got to do it. So a big thank you to our partners for the vlog, Kampala Serena Hotel, who were as kind as to say, you must be tired. Come. We'll give you pancakes, we'll take care of you, give you a massage, and just let you rest. So we got to do that. So yeah, here is day two of my weekend. So here's the thing I might have forgotten to tell you. While I was here at the Serena, I've always been bombarding Mercy, telling her, you need to show me the presidential suite. And not, you know, if you're going to have bold dreams like I've told you, it means once in a while you check into the presidential suite. I'm just saying. So I'm going to work hard. But I said, I want my people to see what a presidential suite at the Serena looks like. And eventually she said, you know what? It'll be like my end of year gift to you. So thank you, Serena. They're going to show us their presidential suite. I hope I did not embarrass you guys with my excitement. Here goes. Maybe you can share in the comments what's been your biggest lesson for 2019. And until 2020, allow me to say Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let me see if I can hug you today.